Hello everyone, today I'm going to be talking about Bulgaria. The country is located in Europe, in the southeast part of the Balkans, and it's actually the only European country that hasn't changed its name since it was first established in 681. Now that's what I call persistence. The country borders Romania, Serbia, Macedonia, Greece, and Turkey, and also the Black Sea to the east. The Black Sea, which is not as scary as it sounds, it's actually a quite important sea since it connects the southeastern part of Europe with Western Asia. It combines the two. Plus, it attracts a lot of tourists who, amongst many other places, visit the giant seaside resort in Bulgaria, Sunny Beach, known for its many, many famous beach parties. In Denmark, there's even a reality TV show called Summer in Sunny Beach. I'm gonna use this opportunity to formally apologize for all the Danish tourists that come to Bulgaria and act like complete s**ts. They literally just around and just f***ing annoying, man. Oh god, how I love my home country. Bulgaria has a very rich culture, literally. I use the word literally too much in my videos, don't I? But anyways, they literally do have a very, very rich culture because the oldest gold treasure was actually found in Bulgaria. Scientists believe it dates all the way back to the 6th millennium BC. The treasures themselves are beautiful. I'm not quite sure what the use of them are though. Probably drinking. I love how humanity hasn't changed at all. They've created these incredibly expensive gold treasures and they just use them as an excuse to get drunk. According to me, at least. Speaking of ancient history, in ancient times, Bulgaria was actually home to the Thracians. The most famous Thracian of all times, of course, being Spartacus, who was famous for leading the slave rebellion against ancient Rome, but nowadays is mostly famous for the TV show Spartacus Tits and Cocks. Oh wait, it's actually Blood and Sand. It's a great show. Freeing slaves or TV star? I wonder what Spartacus would want to be remembered for the most. Other famous Bulgarians include Nina Dobrev, who is mostly famous for starring in the Vampire Diaries. Of course, I have to mention Bulgarian Viktor Krum from Harry Potter as well. And the guy who plays him, who's also a Bulgarian. He's famous for kissing with Hermione. Off screen, that is. Now, did you know that the alphabetic writing system, Cyrillic script, was developed in Bulgaria? Cyrillic script, which is now used around the world in countries such as Russia, Kazakhstan, Belarus, and the list goes on. Bulgaria is also very famous for their Bulgarian yogurt, which is very unique due to its use of the lacto-something Bulgarius bacteria. A bacteria that can only be found in Bulgarian air. So be careful if you're ever flying over Bulgaria, because you might get hit by stray yogurt. No, I'm just kidding. I know there's no such thing as stray yogurt. Yogurt only travel in packs. The capital of Bulgaria is Sofia, which is a largely modern, youthful city. While its old east meets west atmosphere is still very much evident. At least that's what the Lonely Planet says. Ad verbatim. But it really, in fact, is a very beautiful city. So if you ever go to Bulgaria, remember to go to Sofia as well, and not only Sunny Beach or their amazing ski resorts. You need to see Sofia as well. Now, before I finish this video, I need to warn you. If you ever go to Bulgaria, you need to know that nodding your head there means no, and shaking your head means yes, which can be really confusing. And to make matters even more confusing, many Bulgarians have now adopted the rest of the world way of doing it, so now you can never know for sure what a Bulgarian means when they either shake their head or nod their head. So skiing, good yogurt, and gold treasures, and people who you don't know whether they're saying yes or no. Who wouldn't want to go to a place like that? Good job, Bulgaria! So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!